So good morning everyone. It's a great honor and privilege and pleasure for me to be here. Once again, let me welcome all of you to this conference. Now, my job as a CEO, actually there are many things which I do, but one of the things which I do is to travel. I travel all the time almost, and I go across continents. So, for example, yesterday I came from US, and tomorrow I will go back to India. And one thing it allows me to do is to look at contradictions across the world. So I was in the US, and there was a lot of conversation about unemployment, 8.5%. And of course, Europe is also faced with, I'm also on the World Economic Forum Agenda Council, and we have been debating about youth unemployment in Europe for the last couple of years now. And if you look at India as a demography, which is supposedly a demographic dividend, 65% of the people below the age of 35, just imagine the amount of employment which you need to create to make these people productive. So if you look at any dimension, you can see very serious contradictions across the world. Look at healthcare, for example. In US, healthcare, we spend about 21% of the GDP today. Actually, the last time I looked at the number, it was 16%. And this time around, I was reading a report which said we are spending 21% of the GDP on healthcare. India, I don't think, can afford to spend more than 2%. India will not be able to spend more than 2%. India, if you look at it, 70% of the population is in rural India, and 75% of the healthcare is in the urban world. So while you have 75% of the healthcare facilities in the urban world, you have 70% of the population living in rural part of the country. Look at education. In US, the higher education is becoming almost unaffordable for most people. Whereas if you look at India, you can see that India produces 700,000 engineers every year, but you have millions of children who are not in school. So we live in a world of contradictions. We live in a world of inequality. We live in a world where we need to create inclusiveness. While over the last many years, we have seen tremendous amount of improvement in quality of life, it is not inclusive. It is still, you know, very regional, and there are many challenges which are yet to be addressed, and that requires growth, but more importantly, it requires inclusive growth, right? Inclusive growth across the world. Now, various segments are grappling with this issue. You have governments who are grappling with this issue. They need to create reforms, they need to give leadership, they need to create hope. You have businesses which are grappling with this issue. Businesses need to finally, and actually I believe that they really need to honor the social contract. If you look at businesses, you debate this whole issue with shareholder fairness versus stakeholder fairness. You know, businesses tend to be very shareholder focused, whereas what you need is stakeholder fairness. How do you run a business in a legal and ethical manner so that you are fair to all the stakeholders, that is the client, the employees, the investors, and the society itself? Because most of the business, actually all of the businesses, operate in a social environment where we use resources from the social environment to create profit as well as to run the business. So businesses have a responsibility to lead to the front, to honor the social contract which they sign up when they start creating these large organizations. Now, you of course have society, which is a big responsibility. I think more than society, I think all of us, you, me, everyone else, also have a personal responsibility going forward. Because I think the only way to create a responsible society is to have responsible citizens. And that is how you create a responsible society. So each one of these segments, whether it is governments, business, or society, all of these are grappling with, and even at the personal level, we are grappling with these issues of inclusive growth. Now, at the same time, you are also having to create this growth in a resource-constrained environment. Now, we are already using 1.5 times the available resources. If you look at the future, and if you cannot create this growth in a sustainable manner, you have a great challenge in your hands. See, some of the numbers are really scary. By 2025, 1.8 billion people will be living in countries or parts of the world where there will be serious water shortage. And of course, you can hear the various predictions saying that the next war is going to be on water. So you not only have to create this inclusive growth, you have to create in a sustainable manner. Right? And so that means to create quality of life, to create even basic amenities to billions of people, we need to have sustainable, inclusive growth. Now when I come to these events, I think these are extremely important. And these are the events where these stakeholders, whether it is government, and I can see different parties here, whether it is government, society, business, and other stakeholders, these are events where we get together. These are events which we get a chance to interact. And I clearly believe that these interactions will eventually lead to insights, and that is what I am seeing in various other forums. In fact, I was not a Rio 20, but my colleague was, and I was discussing with him. There is a lot of energy, a lot of interaction, a lot of insight. Impact is yet to come. If you look at some of the forums. So, but if I look at my own participation in the World Economic Council, Economic Forum, actually last year, we created some impact on unemployment by piloting a program called Teen Youth Program, where businesses signed up to take small number of interns to create employment for teen youth. So I can clearly see that these forums create an opportunity for interaction, it leads to insights, and then finally they lead to impact. So I'm very happy to be here. I clearly believe that these forums are extremely important. It allows us to act on these three I's, the interaction, the insight, and the impact. And these are the ways for us to make progress, to give leadership, as well as to move towards sustainable, inclusive growth. With that, let me once again welcome all of you to this conference. Thank you very much.